Yes, thank you. Thank you also for inviting me here. I'm Wilma van Wezenbeek. I work for a national program that's called NPulse in the Netherlands. And my job title is a captain of transformation for digital educational resources. And perhaps it's handy to tell a bit more about the program. It's focused on the Dutch educational institutes. That's more than it's over 100. And these are all the public vocational education training schools, the universities of applied sciences, and research universities of the Netherlands. And the program has an overarching ambition so that we collaborate to improve the quality of education. And we increase the agility of the system, of the educational system. And we enhance the digital skills of both lecturers and learners. And perhaps also to tell just a bit more about myself, I bring with me my experience as a director of service units at two research universities. And it is most recently the one at the VU Amsterdam. I was responsible for student and educational affairs. And before that, I was director of the Theodof Library. And open education and open science are and have always been in my portfolio. Yeah, perhaps I would like to take this one level higher. I think open itself is important. So if we want to accelerate and strengthen our knowledge and economy, we should tear down barriers that prevent us from, obtaining this knowledge. And we want to strengthen our knowledge to solve societal challenges. Current changes in society call for a rapid transformation, and that means also for education. And so we must actively build and adjust, and being agile, as I mentioned earlier. We need an education sector that really organize itself smartly and strongly from within, and a sector that is resilient and anticipates on these society's changes and demands. And I personally always make the connection between open science and open education. So open science, they say, is just science done right. And it touches upon all public values, that is on autonomy, justice, humanity. So open education, I guess, is just education done right. And in analogy to research output, we want our educational output to be fair, to be findable, accessible, interoperable, reusable, and open as possible. Specifically for the materials we create ourselves in our institutes. And I always say, let's not forget, we are knowledge institutes. We want our knowledge to flow freely, and we want to learn from others. We want our digital sovereignty guaranteed and our public values protected. Best way, I think, to answer this is to explain a bit more what we in the Netherlands are now doing on national level in this program, NPulse, and then within the Transformation Hub, the Digital Educational Resources, in which I'm involved. So our ambition is that we realize easy access to digital education resources for everyone, wherever they are. And if we realize this, we promote equity of knowledge and opportunities, and we stimulate quality and innovation of education. And a condition for this is that all digital education resources will be 100% fair and shared as open as possible. So our program will end in 2032, so we have still 8 more years to go. But what helps to improve the influence of open education, I think that was your question, is I guess that we realize that we have a shared purpose. So we are united as education sector in this National Growth Fund program, and we have in the Netherlands our governmental coalition agreement that gives us guidance. It says that open science and open education should be the norm. So that's our shared purpose. And we make the educational resources or digital education content fair and as open as possible. And that we help lecturers or teachers all over the world to be able to also retain, reuse, revise, remix, and redistribute. And because that will let knowledge flow more freely and prevents double work, stimulates collaboration and innovation, and that is, as said, what society needs. Yeah, so I think it's important that you organize yourself on all these levels. So at first, the program is then coordinated by the institutes, but also by CERF. That's the collaborative organization for IT in the Dutch education and research. And it's under supervision of the Ministry of Education, Culture and Science. But we're also internationally linked. So I think one thing is that our key for success will be the change within the institutes themselves. That is why we work hand in hand, of course, with the institutes. And to have a more global cooperation, to have global impact. For instance, if we pick one of our challenges, and we need to share as public sector what we mean with digital sovereignty and understand how we protect our public values. And we have to take a shared stand towards vendors, being small or big etter. And we want to prevent logins or abuse of privacy or prices that are sky high. So I think via existing global or European networks, such as OE Global, Spark Europe, KEN, the Knowledge Equity Network, and participating in working groups of the European Digital Education Hub, working with shared standards, lobbying for opposition on governmental level, I think we can all reach the ambition to open up our education and knowledge. Yeah, I have one or two, I think, more statements, not really a question, but I repeat this wherever I can. And one is that we should make sure that we work with persistent identifiers for all our learning materials. So don't forget that. And another one is we stop working in silos so that we really open up and align open science, open access, and open education. And I really would love to hear from viewers or listeners what they do and think about how we can strengthen ourselves even more to reach fair and open education. And my shout out is, let's make education open. Let's make digital educational resources 100% fair.